public library. All these people are here for one message. It's to tell you that a very long time ago, a person by the name of Hussain, the son of Ali, he fought for peace. He fought against injustice. He fought against oppression. He died many, many years ago, but here today, his message is eternal. Anytime there's oppression in the world, everyone here has to stand up against it as Canadians, as human beings. No one wants to think to you! No one crying for her brother. Oh, Hussain, come back to us. Restore order to the campground and please fulfill your one trust. In agony we wail and cry.
Sunday. Why are these people dressed in black? What are they doing here? We'll tell them. And they know. We are so very responsible for our lives. We're responsible as Canadians to show everyone of the oppression around the world. Everyone has to become aware. Everyone has a responsibility to take part to make sure that everyone knows about the injustices that are happening in the world. 1400 years ago, there was a man by the name of Hussain, son of Ali. He fought for peace. He fought against injustice. He fought against oppression. You're saying, why should I care? I'm not Muslim. I don't care about this. Well, you should care. As a Canadian person, you have to make sure that anyone who is oppressed around the world, you stand up against them. You make sure that everyone knows that they are being oppressed. That we, as human beings, we as Canadians, we love those people. We stand against the oppressors. We stand against the people that are creating the injustice. One last time.
Oh, my dear Hussain. Oh, my dear Hussain.
Please, everyone, keep the sidewalk clear. Try to get cozy on the road, because people have to go by. We don't want to bother anyone. Please get on the road and stay off of the sidewalk. Jazakallah alf khair.
Thank you all for coming out today. Your presence is greatly appreciated. Mashallah, it's nice to see our communities in such great numbers to walk with Imam Hussain. Because time is pressing on, I would like to invite brothers Mustafa Juma and Ali Jaber for Quran recitation and translation.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. لقد كان لكم في رسول الله أسوة حسنة لمن كان يرجو الله واليوم الآخر وذكر الله كثيرا. ولما رأى المؤمنون الأحزاب قالوا هذا ما وعدنا الله الله ورسوله وما زادهم إلا إيمانا وتسليما. من المؤمنين رجال صدقوا ما عاهدوا الله عليه فمنهم من قضى نحبه ومنهم من ينتظر وما بدلوا تبديلا ليجزي الله الصادقين بصدقهم ويعذب المنافقين إن شاء أو يتوب عليهم إن الله كان غفورا رحيما. صدق الله العلي العظيم.
For you and the Messenger of Allah. for the one who has hope in Allah and the last day and remembers Allah purposely. When the believers saw the coalition forces, they said, this is what Allah and His Messenger had promised to us. And Allah and His Messenger had told the truth. It only improved them further in faith and submission. Among the believers, there are men who came true to the covenant they had with Allah. So some of them have fulfilled their vows by sacrificing their lives in the way of Allah. And some of them are still waiting, and they did not change their commitment in the least. All this happened so that Allah may give reward to the truthful ones for their truthfulness, and punish the hypocrites, if He so wills, or accept their repentance. Surely Allah is most forgiving, very merciful. Salawat.
Please, we're causing a disturbance for all the passersby. I urge you please come and join the main crowd. Invite Sheikh Salim Genji to say a few words. Salawat.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. I begin in the name of God, the most compassionate, the most merciful. May the peace, mercy, and blessings of God be upon all of you who are here today. First off, I wanted to thank everybody for being here today, especially those who are from outside of our faith tradition and are witnessing this procession here this afternoon in downtown Vancouver. Many of you are probably wondering who this Hussain is, whose name you might see on some of the banners, and whose name we have been chanting through this procession here this afternoon. I don't want to go into much of the specifics. You can go to the back corner and there is a table set up which will give you some more details of who Hussain is and why we are gathered here this afternoon to commemorate his legacy and his mission. But in a nutshell, the Hussain that we have gathered here today, together today to remember is one of the grandchildren of the Prophet Muhammad. He was born 14 centuries ago, 1400 years ago, in a land obviously quite far away from where we are in Canada today. And his culture and his language and religion was quite unique compared to what we have today in Canada. However, when we look at his legacy, which is celebrated across the world by both Muslims and non-Muslims alike, we realize that his ideological stance and what he stood for 14 centuries ago should resonate with us as Canadians as much as it did for those whom he was speaking to so long ago. We're not only here to celebrate his birth, but we're also here more importantly to commemorate his death, because he was killed in one of the most brutal fashions that humanity has ever seen. And in fact, he was actually in a desert plain of the city of Karbala with only about 100 of his family and friends, and they were put up against an army of over 30,000 individuals who had come to stand up against freedom and justice and equality for humanity, not only in his era, but for all time to come. And in these days, the reason why you see all of us dressed in black is because we are recreating or commemorating the martyrdom anniversary of Hussein and his family, which happened 1,377 years ago today. Again, he was killed with his children, his six-month-old son, and many other friends and supporters who also stood for the same values that we as Canadian Muslims cherish and value every day as we live in this beautiful country. Primarily, when we gather as a Muslim community, we gather because of our understanding of him being the successor of the prophetic mission. But we believe him not only to be the successor of Prophet Muhammad, but we believe that he is the successor of all of the prophets that came before him, including Adam, including Prophet Noah, including Prophet Moses, Abraham, including the great revolutionary Prophet Jesus, and obviously his immediate successor, the Prophet Muhammad, may God's peace and blessings be upon all of the great prophets of God. One of the lessons that we try to impart to our community members in our nightly gatherings, and which I wanted to share with all of us who are here today, is that even though Hussain is a religious figure for us, but we believe that his mission, his message, transcends religion. It transcends culture. It just transcends all of the man-made boundaries that we have put amongst ourselves as Canadians and as humanity. And so when I look at his message, I want to share just three points that I derive from the message of Hussain, which will resonate hopefully with all of us who are here today. The first thing that we see is that Hussain was not afraid to take a stand against rights, to be one who was fighting for human rights, one who was not afraid to give his life and that of his family when he believed deeply in a cause which was so cherished by him. Again, I mentioned that he was a man with an army, a so-called army of 100 individuals, but yet he confronted tyranny and stood in the face of 30,000 people who are ready to shed his blood. This shows us that even us today, that we as Canadians have a responsibility to ensure that we stand for justice wherever injustice is happening, whether that be in the Far East, whether it be in Africa, whether it be even in Canada. If we see injustice happening, as we see in so many cases around North America today, where we have Occupy movements that have happened to stand against economic injustice, or whether we see the plight of the African Americans in the Black Lives Matter movement, or indeed even our own First Nations in Canada who have been put on what they call reservations to keep them outside of enjoying the benefits and the fruits of the Canadian society. As Muslims, we believe that we have to stand with all of these examples of injustice. Again, no matter what religion, no matter what dispensation those people who are being oppressed follow. It's not a matter of religious rights, it's a matter of human rights. We also see of one of the messages that we get from the grandson of the Prophet Muhammad is the importance of removing ignorance from our midst. In fact, even the father of Imam Hussain, he has told us in a saying that people are the opponents of what they don't know. When I don't know my fellow neighbor, when I don't know about what religion they follow, or even if they don't subscribe to any religion, when I don't know who they are, I'll always be apprehensive, I'll be wary of interacting or dealing with them. And so Islam shows us that we need to be equipped with knowledge of everybody, not just ourselves, but to remove the fear that we have for the other is based upon the obligation of seeking knowledge about the other. And so when we see issues of insensitivity amongst Canadians or humanity on a whole, or discrimination against so-called minorities, or we have any form of hatred against any nationality, any religion, any culture, whatever ways of life they follow, whatever preferences of life that they have, we might not agree with them, but we can agree to disagree and respect them as being part of the same human family. And so one of the lessons that I impart to myself and the community and all of those who are listening is that we use the mission of Hussain to educate ourselves about that what we don't know. And don't go to Google, because Google doesn't have all of the answers. You have a few hundred Muslims in front of you here today. Many of them have signs that you can ask them if you want to know more about this religion, about this procession that we have today, or you go to the back corner and ask from the people at the table, and they'll be sure to give you an answer that will hopefully give you a better understanding of the religion of Islam. And last but not least is that from Hussain we learn the importance of political involvement. You know, sometimes we feel that, well, what does our vote mean in the system, in the society that we live in today? and especially when we see what's happening south of the border, that sometimes we lose hope in our government and in the entire process. But I think our last federal election in Canada last November, October, November, shows us that as Canadians, when we go to the ballot box and when we put our vote in, we have the ability to change the system. We don't change it through violent means. We don't deal like that. We don't follow that methodology. We have a civilized system. We deal with it. We work it through the process. And so Hussain shows us that, although he had to take another route, but we see that obviously diplomacy is the best way forward, and that we use our political system to enact change to ensure that we have the government that best represents us as Canadians, and that we're able to benefit from, again, all of the fruits that this country has to offer us. Let me close by once again thanking everybody for being present here today. And again, I would urge each and every one of you, if you don't know about Islam, if you have never met a Muslim, that today is a good opportunity for you to meet and greet and talk to any one of us. None of us will be embarrassed or shy or will hide anything. We're all here open, and that's the reason why we're here today, is to show our openness to the society, to the country that we live in, that we have nothing to hide about our religion. We might not have every answer that you are looking for, but we'll do our best to get you the answers and to answer your concerns or questions about the religion of Islam and a faith which is obviously practiced by 1.8 billion human beings upon this earth. Again, thank you very much, and may the mercy and blessings and peace of God be upon all of you who are here today. Thank you.
For your insightful and encouraging words. Now I would like to invite Sister Zahra Kanji for some verses of poetry. Salawat.
My own mislabeled, and I'd like to dedicate it to all those who've unjustly lost their voice. We are not just numbers, no. We are people, flesh and bones, body and soul. We feel just as you do, even when the media lets you believe otherwise. We are not terrorists. I was 5 years old when my mother told me not to believe everything I saw on TV. With all the curiosity a five-year-old could muster, I say, not even the news? I asked, she replied, especially not the news. I had a dream the other night that turned into a nightmare. There was massacre and terror and unthinkable cruelty. Then I woke up and found that it in fact was the reality we live in today. We have seen tragedies that remind us that the injustice that was present 1400 years ago still prevails. The hatred persists, that time doesn't heal all wounds, and that ignorance is deadly. We are not numbers, no, but if you and I could be, we would be one, because one day, instead of all the name calling and hate, maybe you and I could talk about peace. As humanity, we've learned to love our bodies more than our souls, the sun more than rain, and uniformity more than difference. We dress our bodies with clothes, don't we? But we forget that words dress the thoughts we have. Love, justice, forgiveness, peace, happy words. Oppression, misery, abuse, terror, tears, words. I was 10 years old when life taught me that words can be sweeter than honey or sharper than a sword. Swords bring about tragedy. They pierce you and leave you gasping for air. But tragedies have a unique way of uniting humanity, but tell me why. Why does it take people to lose their lives for us to realize that our best friends are not just those who pray the same way we do, but those also whose hearts beat to the same tune of justice? Muslims are in the spotlight. Terror reigns over our lives, and these days we mourn death more than we celebrate life. Our tears are flowing, our hearts are weeping, our souls are shattered, and our minds are grieving. We are not just numbers, no. We are people. We are the H in Husseini and the L in love. We are the brushes made of dreams and colors made of hope, so you can see that our canvases are about peace, not war. We are the words of a love poem, waiting to be read by those who are convinced that we are violent when all we are is misunderstood. We are the pieces of a lost puzzle, looking for the picture we belong to, and no, it is not the one filled with senseless violence and hate. Because we are human, and what humanity needs right now is more peace. Thank you.